Hey Capricorn, it's me, Stormy, and here's your horoscope for October 2018. Before we jump in, Cap, let's handle a little business. So the 2018 holiday gifts are up. Make sure you take advantage of those discounted appointments. I believe that the only spots available that are left are the ones in January. So if you're interested in taking a look around birthday time at what's been going on, all of the new movements we've got going on, or you just want to see how to full steam ahead, let's jump in and take a look. So in the description box, or come see me at stormygrace.com. Okay, Capricorn, so this month, the big ticket item I think is actually of interest to you because Venus is going retrograde. Now, when Venus goes retrograde, we really look over relationships, value, things of value, but also finance. All of these things actually fall into boxes that I think you find relatively important. Now, if you haven't watched my Venus retrograde video, make sure you check it out. It's the very first one in the October playlist. So check it out so you get a bigger view of what's going on. But as far as it goes, this month, Venus is going to be retrograding in the sign of Scorpio, and this is taking us backwards into your 11th house. Now, Capricorn, what keeps coming to me over and over and over again as I look at the patterning of the month for you is that I feel like because Venus is in retrograde, and retrograde asks us to look back, to go backward, review, re-edit, revise, reconnect, reconciliate, right? I feel like there is potentially a friendship. And this would have been something maybe even important to you, or even a connection to a social group that was very important to you, and it had a break for some reason, and you need some forgiveness here. You need to relook at the value of that. This is really a lot about freedom as well. So being free from something that happened in a friendship relationship. Now, of course, the 11th house has a fair amount to do with just friends in general, grouping of friends, social things, but also long-range plans and goals. What are your ambitions and what are you doing to try and get there, right? Venus in this particular house, I think, is asking you in this retrograde, what's the value of what you're doing? Are you taking valuable steps to move forward? Where do you need to reevaluate how you can be connecting more in this social zone to help yourself move forward after Venus comes out of retrograde, right? So this is really, you know, and also just a small question here. What is your self-esteem look like in your social groups? What do you look like on your social profiles out in the world, right? Is it time to touch up those pictures? Do you have a picture of Capricorn from 10 years ago? Because please, that is like lying. You've got to put a current picture up there. Maybe it's time to redo the headshots or something like that, right? Whatever the social zones are though, you're going to be looking for some refreshing. Now, because it is in the sign of Scorpio, you're not going to be able to avoid it. You're going to have to face the truth of the Scorpio energy in this 11th house. And I'm telling you, some of it is not comfortable, especially if you had it out with a friend or something, or an organization, and you need to go back and clean that up. It'll be time to confront, but you don't have to force it. It's going to come on its own, okay? So that's going to happen on the 5th of the month. Now, as we get to the 8th of the month, we've got a new moon happening in the sign of Libra, which hits the tip top of your chart. So we're looking at the midheaven now, the 10th house. Now, the new moon, we plant the seeds of intention, right? We plant those seeds. We don't know when or how it's going to grow and blossom. We just plant it because we want to have something blossom there. And that's exactly what you're doing in your career zone. Now, I don't just consider it career, but your soul level calling zone. What skill, what talent do you have to give away to the world? Because you could very much so, you could be retired. And what are you doing? What skill are you giving to the world, right? What are you sharing with people around you? Are you helping people use, see, find their resources? That could be something that you're doing for sure. So take into account, even if you don't have a career, what you're doing and how you're moving and your status and how you're known out in the world, this is a great place to start a new version of that or to see how you can help it grow and expand forward into something new. What's the next new miracle you want? Now, the other thing I think of with the new moon being in Libra is it's about equilibrium. It's about balance. Where are you out of harmony or out of balance in your workplace? Where are you out of balance in your public life versus your private life, right? Does your Facebook profile match your real life? Do your photos you're sharing with people match what's really going on the inside, right? Because the first place that balance is going to be from the inside out. So it's a great time to look at that. Now, on the 10th of the month, we've got Mercury moving into Scorpio. So again, the 11th house is going to be busy for you this month. The Scorpio energy is going to be busy for you this month. We've got Jupiter, our biggest benefic planet up there. We've got Venus, our smallest benefic planet, and she's flipped around. And now we've got Mercury in Scorpio. Mercury in Scorpio makes you a phenomenal, phenomenal observer. Okay, here in the 11th house, you may have needed to, like I said, go back over a social group or a social whatever, and Mercury is giving you clarity. Mercury's not retrograde. He's still facing front, and he's like, nope, we need to change this. We need to adjust this. Oh, we could use this, and we could make this better. Or the other thing it does is it helps you get out and hustle. It helps you get out and talk to these people in the social groups. Go back to that old friendship. Venus is phenomenal for bringing back past romantic relationships as well, so maybe something like that is breezy into your life, whether it's the actual person or it could just be a vision or a memory or a dream or something like that that comes back to you, and then you have some clarity on how to do something with that. Mercury is just delicious when it comes to helping you communicate, make decisions, or see the strategy behind something. So, you know, you want to change how you're moving and shaking in the world, you got to align with some new people. Now, on the 23rd, we've got the Sun also entering into the 11th house here. Where the Sun goes, it brings light, heat, life, vitality. You want to be known. You want to be seen, right? So here in the 11th house, you're trying on purpose to heal this area, to fluff this area up, to give it life so that you have the social status that you need to move forward, the social backing, the tribe, the correct profiles, right? All of these things in the socials you're doing. This even includes relooking at what you need to / want to do to set this new long-range goal and plan into place, okay? Now, on the 24th, we've got a full moon happening in the sign of Taurus, a fellow earth sign. So first things first, this hits your fifth house, but where do you need to reground? In your fifth house, with your children, with your own self-expression, with maybe a new business you've got going on. Maybe this is a wonderful energy of conception, right? So where do you need to reground? This is a wonderful place to look at this. Now, the full moon says something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So you could be, you've just had a new moon at the top of your chart. Now you've got a full moon at the bottom part of your chart. So what could be happening here is you could be having a career swap, right? Maybe you're speaking up more at work and this leads to a promotion. Maybe you're speaking up and you gain a voice in your community, right? It could be any one of these things. Maybe this is with your children. Right? You could have things going on with children, and I keep that pretty open because maybe you're conceiving at this time, maybe you're delivering at this time, maybe one of your children has something that's ending and getting ready to start something new. It's a really delicious kind of energy, I think, to be looking at. And I would also look at here too, I'm getting a vision. I hate to say that. It's not a vision. It is a vision. Okay, it's a vision, y'all, of maybe looking at material things in this area. Do you need new business supply? Are you trying to start a new business and you need supplies, or you need, what's the material thing that needs to be adjusted here in your fifth house space? To include, are you speaking up? Are you speaking up for what it is that you need in your joy space? What's gonna bring more joy and passion into your life? Maybe it's time to adjust and speak up for that, okay? Now, when we get to the 26th of the month, the Sun and Venus are actually in conjunction up here in Scorpio. So this brings a change, a shift to your social relationships. Now, already having the Sun in Scorpio, you're looking for this transformation energy. So in order to transform, you're gonna be aligned with some new people, places, and things, and this is to your best interest. As well, if you will make peace with whatever the friendship was, the organization was, whatever it was, that comes back up or comes into your head, if you will make peace with that, it's almost as if instead of being held back by it, you gain an ally, or you at least gain the freedom of energetic movement, which you may need right now. It's, of course, you know, going to be an energy while Venus is here where you're relooking over your relationships. And we're going to do that a little bit more as we get into November. So on the 31st of October, Venus is going to take that retrograde on the road, moving out of Scorpio, moving into the sign of Libra. So boom, right here, we've got relationships that we're looking at. And they are connected to who you are out in the world, who you are, who you're being, your job, your career, your soul level calling. I'm telling you, Capricorn, maybe the plan did not unfold the way you thought it should or you were going to have it. Maybe you're in a situation right now that scares the crap out of you. And I think that Venus shows up here to say, it's okay. It's okay to reevaluate this relationship and see that it is okay for you to be loved. It is okay for you to have financial success. It is. These things are okay, right? So I also think that this Venus retrograde here on the 31st and as it runs through November gives you an opportunity to have a new relationship of you with you. Now, also on the 31st, we've got Mercury moving into the sign of Sagittarius. So this is going to light up the 12th house space for you, a very quiet place. Now, Mercury in Sagittarius is very open-minded. That's why I say if you can make peace this month, because the 12th house is a place of closure, of transition, and you're doing it with a much wider perspective, so likely kind of a spiritual awakening. If you can make peace with the past that comes up for you, if you can share the details of something that's been hidden, right? Something that maybe you haven't been talking about that you needed to talk about. Maybe you just need to say, I'm blessed out loud and actually believe it. If you've been working on a school project or a business plan, something behind the scenes, you can speak it up and into existence now. And as we move into November, it's going to help it unfold. So I think it's going to be a really interesting month. I can't wait to see what revelations, epiphanies, spiritual awakenings come for you this month, because some of them are going to just be really damn practical, right? You can't continue to be mad at blah, blah, blah. Oh, you have to speak up for blah, blah, blah. Oh, this is something you're passionate about. It's time to speak to us about that. There are going to be some pretty practical revelations, I think, as well. It's not just all hoity-toity woo-woo, okay? All right, Capricorn, I hope you have an absolutely fabulous month. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, take advantage of the 2018 holiday gift, and I will see you beautiful goaties in the next month's video, okay? Bye, guys.